Hello, do it yourself people. It's a sunny day in Boston. And I have a little wall there that's two blocks tall, about 2 feet tall, with the top part. I have a neighbor's dog that's also barking, because lots of people are going to their backyard, and the dog was brought in the fall. Oh. And he's not too familiar with the new faces. It's a loudmouth dog, but it's okay. That's a good watchdog. You're looking at my installation of the outdoor lathe. I stuck two poles in the ground and I made sure they are level. Here's my level. This is a long pole that I'm going to turn, so I had to add the extension because the pole has to fit between the posts that are in the ground. So I didn't have to measure, I just used the pole as my measurement and some hose clamps to put some extension. So I left just a little space right here for a few washes. If you can see a little gap there. What happened to my gap? My gap disappeared. Well, that will make it one washer. One washer will do. I had more of a gap, but in pounding the ground, the pole moved a little. That's okay. One little washer will do. And basically, that's it. And this is level. It's completely horizontal. As I explained, these are standard size lumber, so you've got an advantage to build it for standard size lumber. This one is either 8 feet, I think. Could be more, but who cares? That's what they sell. That's what it is. Now I could put another pole further up at a different distance for a different size stock, and a third one and a fourth pole, etc. Like that, I can use pairs of pole depending on what I'm going to turn them for. So even if I have four poles in the ground, I can use the first one and the second one, which is the case here. Or if I have some shorter, it will be the second one and the third one, and so forth. As I mentioned in the other video, outdoors lathe parts, the distances that I suggest in writing were, I think, 4 feet, 3 feet, 2 feet for additional distances. But you know better. You're the one who, when you build yours, you're going to use it to, you know what kind of stock you start with, so make your life easy. Now, these poles are going to stay in the ground. The long horizontal piece is going to be out of here. And I'm going to grow a garden right here with my little pole sticking out. I'm most likely add a third one. And I can add a fourth one to the left. But as things stand now, I have no plans for this lathe other than to build it and show it to the world. That's all I'm doing. If in the future I have another column to make, I have enough space between the height of the pole and the ground to turn a 6x6, I have to make another pulley. But that's 5 minutes of introduction, so I better get back to work and screw some screws and make sure this thing spins while the sun is up. Thank you. Oh well. After I close the camera, I realize that I won't be happy without the gap there. So I did some more pounding of the ground and I put a wedge there to leave space for washes. I think this space will be enough for washes on both sides. Big wide washes. As long as the turning piece does not touch the post, that's all I want. I'm going to soak it all with water. It's going to rain tonight, and by morning I'll be ready to rumble. Okay. All right. Here's one stick. Here's another stick. Who knew that you could have just two sticks in the ground and have a lathe? I think they will be fine in the garden. Two sticks in the ground with 2 tons of dampening dirt in between to keep the vibration down, and we'll have a lathe. I will be drilling a center hole there, and another one in this one. Now, as for my tool rest, I found this piece of metal from another bed, bunk bed, I believe. Bunk bed made out of metal. These things come out in the sidewalk once in a while. And I always pick raw material that's being discarded. Otherwise, they're going to cost me a bunch of 99s. In the sense of $9.99, $19.99, $29.99, $99.99. I got the shopping blues. Alright, so that's the plan. Drill holes. Then, maybe dig 3 more holes for this resting metal beam. I don't want to just support it at the end, even though it has these lips with holes in the mud. That will not be enough. I'd rather give it some support in the middle. I don't like things that are supposed to be straight but curve in the middle due to gravity. Gravity can cause a lot of trouble, especially in electronics. You have a wide circuit board at the bottom of the TV. In the span of 5 to 10 years, it's going to curve due to gravity in the middle. The middle will sink and crack your thin layered connections. Anyways, I'm not an electronic person. I'm just a mechanical man. I'm just explaining to you a mechanical problem with electronics. So that's all it takes to have an outdoor lathe. Who knew? Just 2 sticks in the ground. Later. 3/8, 7/16, 1/2. 10 years ago, I was lucky enough to find these 3 drill bits. For 99 cents. I don't know if you can see the label, but that's what it says. It was 197, today 99 cents. Anyways, I will use the middle one, 7/16, to drill in this beam. And I think the 1/2 inch will do fine in the post. Later. Okay, I traced 2 diagonal lines at the end of the beam, and now I'm about to start drilling. First, I'll drill with a small drill bit so I don't miss the center. A large drill bit will slide and make me miss the center. I'm pressing it. I'm not busy with a location. I'll relocate. And something like that. This is the turn. I'm not 100% pleased with how I started, but I'm removing some wood shavings. So the large drill bit will find center. There we go. Now the large drill bit, that thing is dancing. I just bent it maybe here. Maybe that's why it was cheap. I think something wrong with my drill. It's an old flea market drill. Anyways, time to drill. Now let me check that this hole is not too big for my screw. It's too big. It's not good. Will it screw? It will screw. Excellent. So we'll just drill on. We just continue drilling. There's no stopping us now. Is the important part here. I do it all over here so it will come past the screwing part. Excellent. Get to do the other side. In a minute I'll show you the rest. Here we go again. I rotated the piece. Going to trace a couple of diagonals. One die, two die, diagonals. This was perfect. I'm seeing some shade, so I put the ruler below so I can see where it's located clearly in the sun. Oh well, one line is enough. Here I am tracing another one. That looks good. There we go. My bit. Small bit first. Excellent. I have a vise at the other end, keeping the whole beam from sliding. I gotta clean this. I hated it with a screwdriver, but it's a good 99 cents. Alright, here we go. I'll take this 3/8. That was 7/16. But the 3/8 is longer. I'll go a distance with a longer one in case I have to screw the screw tighter. Don't take chances. No need to crack it.
Later.
I put the longer bit in place there, pretty long. So I go as far as I can, and I'll go in another end. Now we're cooking. And let's compare to the screw. That will take the whole screw. Let's make sure of that. Without the washers even. Yeah, that will cook it. Alright. So I'll do the other side. And in the next video, we'll find things spinning. For now, get digging. Well, let me say something here if I can put my head in the view. It's been a while since I've been out there working, and it's great to see that winter is finally over and I'll be working in the garden, and hopefully I'll be constructing wind turbines, alternators. And I think I'll stay away from the wood shop for a while. But I just wanted to let this one out. Thank you. Bye-bye.